Coral reefs are much more than an underwater playground or an enticing picture in a travel brochure. They hug a band around the world between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. Nestled in warm, shallow waters, they create one of the richest environments on Earth, nurturing over a third of all fish in the sea, over 4,000 species. But coral reefs are in danger.
Coral reefs have been very stable for a long time, and it's only really within the last 30 years where we've seen these dramatic changes from what we were accustomed to, where a reef went from a coral-dominated system to a system where algae came in and took over and basically covered the bottom.
Surprisingly, one of the main causes of this crisis in coral reefs is disease, which takes advantage of the coral's basic structure. Reefs are built from very simple organisms called coral polyps, basically just a mouth and a stomach. At night, they open up, and their stinging tentacles wait for prey, little larvae, and plankton. Like clams and oysters, these coral polyps secrete calcium carbonate, also called limestone, creating little rooms to live in. Sticking together, these compartments create beautiful shapes and provide protection. But the fixed structure allows diseases to spread very quickly. One, white plague number two, can move half an inch a day, killing the little coral polyps as it advances, leaving a dead skeleton behind. Coral diseases can be caused by fungi, bacteria, or viruses. One notorious culprit is a nasty comma-shaped bacteria called Vibrio. In one form, it causes cholera. And other variations live naturally in coral polyps. The theory is, with stresses like global warming and pollution, corals are now weak and less able to fight off these pathogens. And there are more and more diseases. White syndrome, white plague, black band, Caribbean yellow band, growth anomalies, dark spots, red band. And these diseases threaten to wipe out whole species of coral fast. In the Caribbean, white band disease is the primary cause of a drop of over 80% in staghorn and elkhorn coral.
So elkhorn coral died throughout the region in the 1970s and the 1980s from disease. Most places that you go today, what you see are graveyards of skeletons. These corals are still standing in place, dead.
This outbreak of coral diseases started in the Caribbean, but is now spreading to the Pacific, Asia, and even the coasts of Australia. But the picture is not completely bleak. Researchers are beginning to catalog and understand the bewildering array of threats to the reefs. And sometimes, as here in Jamaica's Pedro Bank, scientists like Andrew Bruckner of the Living Oceans Foundation can find a reason for optimism.
A lot of the corals are doing really, really well down there. There's quite a lot of big star coral colonies.
Which is surprising, because star coral, which can live for thousands of years, was all but wiped out by white plague disease starting around the year 2000.
We really haven't been seeing a lot of that coral anymore, or colonies that are, you know, large, half a meter to a meter tall, that are still in really good shape.
Healthy star coral is vital because it's the basic building block of Caribbean reefs. And even the almost extinct staghorn and elkhorn coral are fighting on.
What we saw out there was, you know, a couple dense patches, which is a sign that they're coming back.
As Andrew Bruckner has seen, the ocean can surprise us with its resilience. So by expanding research and conservation, we can help the coral reefs return.